end zone. The Knights will be taking over from the 20-yard line. First and 10. Let's see what this offense has in store on their second trip onto the field. Gets the snap this time, takes it out to the 40-yard line, second and one on its way. By Michael Jefferson, taken down by number 23 in white, Jordan Cleaves. 5-yard gain will make this a second and 5. Donahue to Pritchard is caught clean. It's good enough for a first down.
Thank you.
is 6 points on the board. For the Rams. Oh, Whitaker once again. In the middle of it is 82, Zion Hodges.
Thank you.
AJ Neely hauls in another catch. He's pushed out of bounds, but not before a first down nine. Charlie Pritchard is going to fall incomplete. Second and 10 now for the Knights. Scamper sets the Knights up in the 10-yard line. It is first and goal, Knights.
Thank you.
we want to continue to remind you that a few items. One, our concession stand is open. It's almost halftime. The line's going to be long, so beat the Rockies. Get there now. Pull for pizza, burgers, candy, drinks, you name it, they probably have it. Additionally, the 50-50 ticket raffle is still going on. Find the yellow sign. 50% of the proceeds will head to the boys' track team. And 50% might end up in your pocket. At this point, the total pie is over $600. Later in the second half, we'll flip the winner. We'll head out of bounds. Get you that. So the Rams will go up and start their drive at the 35-yard line. First and 10 on its way. Once again, I want to give a big thank you to HES Facilities Management and the State Bank of the Lakes for supporting the GHS Athletic Boosters Club. If you have a towel or a giveaway for the Boosters, there's a good chance it's because those organizations helped fund that. So, once again, thank you to those two organizations. Central, but it will be declined. That's because with that loss, we have a third down. Thank you. This has fourth down time. The Rams have the punt team on. Player kicks there by the road, DJ Neely. The Knights take over, first and 10. And the penalty is over tonight. It'll back them up a few yards. It'll remain though first down. Donahue intended for Jefferson Falls, incomplete. It'll be third and one, 25 seconds remaining in the first half.
It's all good. I like it all good. I like your comments.
Donnie Lattimore, Don Pulliam with the first down run. DJ Neely spinning defenders around as he scampers out of bounds, stopping the clock. First down, nine! And a pass over the middle from Donnie Hughes falls to the ground, incomplete. Third and 10, coming up for the Knights. Some fantastic halftime performances for you this evening. The first that we want to draw your attention to the track. Please welcome our Breeze Lake North cheerleaders. And now, welcome to the field, our varsity team! team is coached by Cassie Copperweight, Copperplate, and Jenny Morgan. Please welcome to the field your very own Grays Lake North Marching Knights. Recently, our Marching Knights performed at the Grays Lake Charity Parade in their own home competition tonight, Marching Tournament, on Sunday, September 11th. The Knights are currently preparing for the Fox River Marching Invitational in Waukesha, Wisconsin. For tonight's halftime performance, the Marching Knights present their 2022 show, Nature of the Beast, featuring music from Justin Chambers, Randall Sandridge, Adam Levine, Radiohead, and Stravinsky. Peyton Chumbly, Isaac Gallegos, and Claire Hickson. Is your band ready? Thank you. can't help myself. Once again, give it up for the Marching Nuns! Thank you. $790. Cut that in half, and you might go home with that much money only if you buy a 50-50 ticket raffle. The other half of those proceeds will end up going to the boys' track team. So it is a win-win, even if you lose. Additionally, I know the rush of the concession stand at halftime is crazy. They will continue being open, though, so head to the concession stand. All proceeds go to our Grizzly Road Athletic Boosters Club. You are being helped out tonight by HES Facilities Management and the State Bank of the Lakes. opening kick in the second half by Central heads out of bounds. That'll be a penalty to start and give the Knights good field position to get this thing underway as we head into the third quarter. Decline the penalty and ready to re-kick. And this one heads into the end zone, meaning the Knights will start their opening drive of the third quarter from the 20-yard line, first and 10. Jefferson complete. 3 yard gain, looks like. First and 4 yard gain in the second and six. See what this is. And penalty is against the Knights. They're going to back up 5 yards, and it'll be second down and 11. from there by number 8, Junior Munoz. Gets a few yards before he's tackled by number 32, Rari Bernardi. Second down and 8 now for Brewery Sycamore. And penalty markers fly. It'll be a false start on the offense. After the penalty, it is now 2nd and 13. To Michael Jefferson, and a fall incomplete. 2nd and 10 now for the Knights. Completed to Cam Bates, number 10. 8-yard pass will result in 3rd and 2. Thank you. down there by number 24, John Pullen. It'll be a gain of 2, second and goal from the 8-yard line. Intended for number 11, DJ Neely. Just a bit too high for him, incomplete. It results in third and goal now for Graves Lake North. Signals incomplete once again, trying to target Neely. And with that, looks like the Knights are bringing on the kicking team. And the Knights need to think it over. Timeout, Graves Lake North. After that timeout, the offense has come back out onto the field. Fourth down. And the pass is batted down by the Rams defense. It'll be a turnover on downs. And the Rams will take over, first and 10, from their own 8-yard line. Jeffrey Ventura! And as we are drawing closer to the end of the third quarter, we want to remind you one last time of the 50-50 ticket raffle to support the boys track team. They're waving around yellow signs. The pot is at 850. Made by number 9, Garrett Gunther, but he's taken down by the whole syndicate of Knights. And it is third down! Again, North fans, make some noise. It is third down!
Thank you.
And the PAT is no good. But that pass from Donna Fiuna Neely is still for six. Your Knights now lead 27-17. That night's touchdown is brought to you by Camp Bow Wow in Lindenhurst. Have a furry friend you want to pamper? Look no further than Camp Bow Wow. Doggy daycare and boarding and grooming are available. The kickoff is returned to the 20-yard line, but there's a penalty marker on the field. Caden Miller, pushed down by number 33, Carter Barenbaum. The result of the play will be a first down, first and 10 for the Rams. Looks like tackle made there by number 38, Tyler McBride, along with 82, Zion Hodges. The run, though, is good enough for a Central first down. Thank you. number 44 on the run for Central, Matthew Jens, taken down by 28, Gavin Mercier. Max Bola, the run by number 4, Jeremiah Almendarez-Poyser, but there are some penalty markers on the field. It'll be against the Rams, low block. Out of bounds, but a penalty marker on the field once again. And the penalty will be against the Knights. Second and 2. Down. and the snap got off in time. Nathan Alfaro on the tackle there will take us to the fourth quarter. With 12 minutes left to play, your Knights lead 27-17. Fans, a moment many of you have been waiting for. It's time to read off the winner of the 50-50 ticket raffle. So if you bought a ticket, take them out. The winner tonight will be going home with $450. That means that $900 was put in. What a turnout. The winner, their ticket reads 916-496. If that's your number, come on up to the press box. Once again, 916-496. If that's your ticket, come on up to the press box and claim your $450. That means that $450 was also given to the boys track team. Before he gets to the sticks. That means it's third down. Make some noise! By Nathan Alfaro. Stop short of the line again. It's fourth down. It looks like the Rams are going for it. Fans, the defense needs your help. Run there by Junior Munoz is stopped. What's up for tackle is made by number 72 on the right, Thomas Newman. It'll be third and six now for the Knights offense. Donahue's pass intended for Neely falls incomplete. That'll bring up a fourth and six situation for the Knights. And it will present the Knights cut team has come off the field. Not only can he throw, but he can kick. Jacob Donahue flips the field, and the Rams will start their next offensive drive at their own 40-yard line. Run there by number 7, Caden Miller. Brought down by 8, Platoon of Grays Lake North Knights. The 5-yard gain will make this 2nd and 5. And that'll be a first down run for Grays Lake Central. Two-string tackle there by Tyler McBride. Brings down Ondar Toiza. A 5-yard gain will make it 2nd and 5 now for Central. The pass intended for number 9, Garrett Gunther, is broken up by number 18, Mitchell Hughes. it's third down. Make some noise. Folks, we don't want the ticket to raffle winner. 916-496. If your ticket was 916-496, come up and claim your money at the press box. Backs the Knights up. It is still first down.
Yeah,
Donahue's run picks up some Negri yardage. Let's not forget a great block there by number 8, Junior Munoz, to free him open. It'll be second down and a little bit more manageable. Run there by Donahue, eventually taken down by Devin White. Well, it looks like that'll be coming back for holding on the night. To pull him. He's taken down at the 25, and a quick timeout is called by Grays Lake Central. It'll be fourth down, coming up for the night. Donahue is taken down by number 44 in white, Matthew Jens, That'll result in a turnover on down. The Rams take over at their own 35-yard line, first and 10. Pavel, good enough for a first down, but he was met by Jimmy Pylas. And Pavel's pass falls incomplete. Looks like that was intended for Sean Mullen. Marker on the field is against tonight's too many men. 5-yard penalty. It remains first down for the Rams. Jefferson now making an impact on the defense. Tackles Omendar's Poyser. It'll remain a first down for Grays Lake Central. The pass falls incomplete, nearly intercepted by Jimmy Pilot. He'll now be second down. 48 seconds to play. They're now 4-0, but they need your support the rest of the way, home and away. Be there to support this team. We also want to give a special thank you to all the alumni who have came back for tonight's homecoming football game. We thank you for your continued support even after graduation. Once a night, always a night. We hope to see you again soon, and go night! Fans, if you lost a cell phone, Mr. DeCalue has that. If you have lost your cell phone, please see Mr. DeCalue. He's standing around the 45-yard line on the sideline. Once again, if you've lost your cell phone, do a check right now. Mr. DeCalue has it. He's around, he's on the sideline, he's on the home sideline. We also have a Toyota key fob on the 50-yard line. I believe the world has that. Folks, go ahead and make sure that you have all of your belongings, especially if you came onto the field. Cell phones, keys. Fans, please check and make sure you have all your belongings, especially cell phones and keys. If you feel as if you may have lost yours, you should find Mr. DeCalue or another administrator. Thank you.
always fun.
Yeah, a real great job too, interrupting. I was listening the whole time. It wasn't even that I was out of it. I was just so into it. And I was like, oh,
that was real.
And then I was like, oh, shoot, they have another song. Oh, my